What's up, everybody? How is everybody doing today? All right. I hope everybody is blessed. I hope you're all doing well, okay? So we're just going to hop right into it, all right? In the vision that I received, right, I saw the enemy plotting, okay? Something about knocking on your door, okay? To approach you, or reach out to you or something like that. Like, if somebody's knocking on your door, they're thinking about approaching you or reaching out to you, okay? And it's somebody that you know of, all right? But they are indeed somebody that you don't fool with at all, okay? You would consider them an enemy, all right? The opposition, okay? Somebody that you oppose, okay? But should they come near you, it's going to be hell to pay, for sure, okay? It's not going to go the way they think it's going to go. It's not going to go nothing like that, all right? To knock on the door, all right? Someone is seeking access. They're seeking access, okay? Because they are knocking, you have to actually give them permission to enter, all right? Always be careful what you allow yourself to be opened up to, all right? Don't give them permission in this season because, again, if they come near you, it's not going to go the way that they think it's going to go. I'm telling you that right now, okay? Somebody is attempting to gain access to your life, okay? Or they have previously attempted. And these people were unsuccessful. They didn't get a chance to even stand next to you. They didn't get a chance to come into contact with you. For real, for real. Every attempt that they have ever made was unsuccessful. It was unsuccessful, okay? But I got you covered. Because I'm bringing you messages from the divine right now, okay? Glory to God, all right? All right? To knock on a door is to approach somebody. To step on the land. To come on the property. And some of these people may not physically just try to. They may try to, you know, however it go or, you know, whatever. But the enemy has already been warned to stay away from you. Literally. You're off limits. You're untouchable, okay? So to those who do so, the consequences, they will be life-altering and life-changing, my God. Okay? Somebody already violated you in the past. And the consequences of that has been rendered. Or it will be rendered. All right? Some people who come across you, they have no clue that you are their destiny helper. They have no clue. All right? You are a destiny helper, but they chose to take another path, okay? They chose to take another route. They chose to come up against you instead. Some people, you got to be careful who you decide to make an enemy because you very well may be putting yourself on the opposite side of God because you don't know God's people. You know what I'm saying? These people, they chose to come against you. The path that they chose to take, it will ultimately be their fate. The path that they chose to take, that's going to be their fate and they're going to reap what they sow. Yeah. All right. Some probably haven't even realized, right, that every time somebody do something to you in any way, it affects more than one person. I'm talking about it affects everyone. It's not just you. I'm talking about it's like a domino effect. You're one of the most rare people in this world. Like, they cannot touch you without it being consequences. My God. Mm-mm. Some people will actually end up cursed after what they did to you or after what they tried to pull on you or after what they tried to do to you. You just don't know how much you are loved by God. And some of these people, again, they're going to end up cursed because that came up against you. These people are marked. They are marked. My God. My God. They are marked. Because they chose to mark you as a target. Because they chose to mark you and leave all types of nasty scars on you. Destroy your face card, your reputation, because they tried to put a hand on you. See, the word of God says, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. Because these people tried to mark you, they in return will be marked. They are cursed. It's a wrap. It's a wrap. See, you're the wrong person to make a target. People can't just make you no target and get away with that. People can't send nobody after you or point somebody in your direction without the Most High seeing them. Yeah. You're the wrong person to plot evil against. It's extremely offensive to God. I'm telling you, people who do this to you, they are attracting the attention of the Most High. And I wish I could get on here and fake it. I wish I could get on here and play with you and tell you a lie. I wish I could. I might tell you a joke, but I never tell you a lie. I'm telling you that. Doing so attracts the attention of the Most High when these people come up against you. You are the apple of his eye. And I don't think they really understand it, but they're going to find out. Zechariah 2:8. For thus said the Lord of hosts, after his glory sent me to the nations who plundered you. For the one who touches you touches the apple of my eye. Yeah. After a period of glory, the Lord of heaven's armies sent me against the nations who plundered you. For he said, anyone who harms you harms my most precious possession. Man. You're the apple of his eye. Put it in the comments. Say the apple of his eye. Somebody touched you. My God. They physically laid a hand on you before, or they physically touched something that belonged to you. They did something. I don't know what they did. They did something to you and it caused some type of something that God is not pleased with. I'm seeing a hand being placed on you. I'm talking about the smallest touch, the smallest offense, the smallest act of wrongdoing, the smallest violation. My God. Some of these people are dead men. They are dead men walking after hurting you or causing harm to you. I'm not trying to scare you. Don't be afraid. But I'm telling you the truth. They're a dead man walking after what they did to you. See, those who mistreat, misuse, ill-treat, ill-use, abuse, molest, damage, injure, wound, cause loss or ruin, grief, trauma, or distress, they got another thing coming. They got another thing coming. They're a dead man walking. I'm telling you that right now. These people are a condemned prisoner. Yeah. They are unfit for use. I'm talking about complete disapproval. Yeah. Some of these people are going to be sentenced to punishment. Especially death.
Yeah.
They are unsafe, dangerous, and unhealthy for you. I'm picking up in the spirit that some will literally be condemned to hell. My God. My God. If they die, they're going to hell. But if they live, they're going to have hell on earth. I'm talking about they will be found guilty. I'm telling you now. Their destiny is to be found guilty. I don't care how they try to get over, how they try to get away, how they try to hide their hands. I don't care how they try to cover up what they did. I don't care what type of tactics they use. I don't care if they thought that they got away. God said, I found them guilty.
Yeah. Guilty. It has been foreordained.
Okay.
What does it mean to be foreordained, okay?
Of God or fate, okay?
A point or decree beforehand. This is going to happen regardless.
They're going to be found guilty, okay? And again, if they die, they're going to hell. And if they live, they're going to experience hell on earth. And whatever that is for them, whatever hell on earth, because see, God know everybody. He knows just how to get you.
Mm-hmm. He know exactly how to get you. Yeah. I'm picking up on pre-doom.
Pre-doom. Condemn or determine the fate of someone or something in advance. It was already
determined in advance.
After they did what they did to you, it was already determined in advance. Let's go.
These people are about to experience public
disapproval.
There is no hope for them. Ain't no hope. If they looking at the situation, trying to find hope in it,
there is no hope. They are hopeless.
They should have never did that to you. They should have never played with you. They should have never, let me tell you something. Some of these people thought that they could do you
the worst way, humiliate you and embarrass you and get away with it. Some of these people thought they could abuse you and use you and take you for all that you got and get away with it.
There is no hope for them. It will not get better for them. They will not succeed. No success can come out of that situation. The devil won't win. And you got to be careful because some of these people who are a
dead man walking, they don't got nothing to lose. They ain't got nothing to lose.
So you got to beware when you're dealing with these dead people.
Because they don't got nothing to lose already.
Man, you better be careful. Their fate has already been determined. They are destined to fail. They are destined to experience hell. I'm telling you what I know. They're a dead man walking. They don't got nothing to lose.
Yeah.
These people, they are about to face
an unavoidable loss.
They're going to take an L. And they can't do nothing about it. They can't do nothing about this. They're about to take
an L or it has already happened. I'm telling you, some people are about to take a loss.
I'm telling you now. They may be free.
Some of these people that I'm talking about, let me tell you something.
Your enemies may be free.
But trust indeed, they're suffering.
They may be walking around here.
They suffering.
Don't listen to him. I'm picking up that somebody is actually doomed. They're doomed. Some of these people know they doomed. They know it. They know they're doomed. Come on now.
What is it to be doomed?
Likely to have an unfortunate
and inescapable outcome. Ain't no running from this.
You can run, but you cannot hide. Run as far as you want to run, as long as you want to run, but you will not succeed. Your enemy will not succeed. The devil will not win. You can run, but you can't hide. Put that in the comments. Say you can run,
but you cannot hide.
Huh. These people are ill-fated. What does that mean? That means they are certain
to fail.
They are certain to fail. Okay? They are destined
to fail. These people are experiencing bad luck right now as we speak.
Or they were. I'm talking about bad luck. Something is not going to work out for them. They should have never crossed you. They should have never did that to you. My God, you a dangerous individual.
A dangerous one to play with.
I'm talking about
These people, they should have never crossed you. And some of them, they crossed you, but they got other people to go against you with them. They ganged up and teamed up with other people, and they all gonna come crashing down. Domino effect, one after the other. They all gonna suffer. They all finna have bad luck. Because see, you can't group up with one fool and think that you don't get the same consequence. It's like somebody committing a crime and then feeling like, oh, well, no, you an accomplice. You was there with them.
They will be found guilty. They are going to be found guilty. Glory to God. Glory to God. It's so serious, right?
That once these people decided to plot evil against you and act on it, once they decided to plot evil and act on it, they are indeed cursed.
Cursed. Cursed. They're gonna begin to lose things. They should have never tried to play with you like that. They should have never did.
God is real.
God is real. And when people come around playing with you,
they're gonna find out just how real God is. God is real. These people are gonna begin to lose things. I'm picking up on homes, cars, businesses,
family members, marriages, partnerships,
properties. They're gonna have unstable relationships.
It's not gonna work out. I'm telling you, some of these people did just so dirty that after they carry on after you, it's never going to work out
because they got to come back and right that wrong, baby. I'm seeing eviction notices, court notices,
debt, late payments, repossessions, loss of possessions in some way. Some people gotta pay. They gotta pay. They're about to take a L.
They have to pay. Yes.
And for some of them, the soil is getting hard to till. It's not gonna be fertile. They're really gonna know what get it out the mud means.
I'm talking about there is no mud.
They're gonna be chiseling through rocks, dry grounds, working so hard. My God.
These people, they must repent.
They got to repent. They got to make it right with God's children.
They got to make it right with your chosen one. Because some of them have been cursed.
They got to make it right with your chosen one. Some people will
not have a stable relationship again.
It will always fail or be chaotic because of the things that they do, because of their nature.
Glory to God.
There is no peace for the wicked. Their strength will be taken. Some people are suffering internally. They're suffering internally. Come on now. They are unwell. They're not well.
You probably can't even tell that they're unwell.
But internally, they're suffering. Mm-hmm. I'm picking up on spiritual poverty. And I want to let you know, it's not a matter of what happens, but when it happens.
Years may go by, but you're going to see it with your own eyes.
The downfall of your enemy. You're going to see it with your own two eyes, baby.
Watch this. Psalms 91:7.
Though 1,000 fall at your side,
though 10,000 are dying around you, these evils will not touch you.
Just open your eyes and see how the wicked are punished. No harm will come near you. Glory to God. You're only going to see it with your eyes.
Okay? And you're going to witness the punishment of the wicked.
You will only be a spectator. You're only going to watch. That's it. You're going to look on with your eyes and witness the divine repayment of the wicked as you watch safely from the shelter of the Most High.
My God, you're going to watch from the shelter of the Most High. You're going to see it. Put your glasses on. You're going to see the downfall of the wicked. You're going to be a spectator.
Yeah. Yeah. You will be a witness.
Put it in a comment. Say, I will be a witness.
Repayment is here. Repayment is here. Put it in a comment. Say, repayment
my God. These people, they must repent and confess to be saved. Because the wrath of God is upon them.
The wrath of God is upon them.
Some people literally have to come back to you and make it right, or they're going to be doomed. That's how serious it is concerning you. Some people think that they can just carry on. They cannot. They cannot. They cannot. They gotta come back. Some people don't have the guts. They don't have the balls. They don't have the capacity. They don't have the audacity to come back and say, look, I did you wrong a couple times.
And I'm sorry about that. I apologize. Just want to right my wrongs. Just want to clear my debt with you.
Yeah, they cursed and they may not even know that they're really cursed. They be unaware. They don't even know it. They don't know that they cursed, y'all. But should these people come across you, they should really right the wrong.
Or it's over with for them. It's a done deal. Okay? Sometimes you just have to make it right, okay? You literally can't carry on and move on from that.
It's not a matter that can be swept under the rug. Some of these situations are not a matter that can be swept under the rug. That's how big it is.
It's humongous. You can't put a mountain under the rug. They're going to have to humble themselves. And they're going to have to address you. Otherwise, it's a wrap for them. Isaiah 3:11, okay? Woe to the wicked.
Disaster
is upon them. They will be paid
back for what their hands have done. Your enemy is about to have disaster.
Or they already received it. My God. But you're going to know because you're going to see it. It shall be ill with him for what his hands have dealt
out
shall be done to him. My God. What goes around comes around. That's the type of season we in. That's how the Most High getting down right now. He said what's done, what they did with their own hands, it's going to be done to them.
It's going to be done to them.
But the wicked are doomed, for they will get exactly what they deserve. Some of these people don't even understand. They're going to be like, Lord, help me. What have I done to deserve this, God? Why?
You're getting exactly what you deserve.
All the tears that they finna cry. All the setbacks they finna have.
All the memories. All the losses they finna take. Man, they're getting exactly what they deserve.
They should have never did that to you.
They should have never did it. They should
have never touched you. Yeah.
Things are about to go badly for them, okay? For what they have done, again, will be done to them. Judgment is coming.
Judgment is coming. My God. What you did to others will come back to you. They're going to get exactly what they deserve. If you're wondering,
I'm telling you right now, I'm giving you divine messages right now. They are going to get exactly what they deserve. If you thought that they wasn't, don't believe me, just watch. They're going to get exactly what they deserve,
my God.
Hebrews 2:2.
After all, the message that the angels brought
was reliable,
proved to be true. And every violation and act of disobedience was properly punished.
You watching an angel right now, and I'm here to deliver a message to you that they're going to get exactly what they deserve. They're going to get exactly what they deserve. Come on now. After all, the message that the angels brought was reliable,
proved to be true, and every violation
and act of disobedience was properly punished.
Come on now. You're going to see the downfall of your enemies.
You're going to hear about it.
You finna hear about it. You're going to hear about it. And you will smile. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid.
Don't be scared.
I'm telling you what's to come. When you hear of these things, you're going to smile.
You will be triumphantly
happy. My God.
Your desire concerning your enemy will be fulfilled.
I'm talking about prayers being answered in this season. All glory goes to God. All glory goes to God. Come on now. Psalms 92:11. My eyes have seen the downfall of my enemies. My ears have heard the defeat of my wicked opponents. I'm talking about glory to God. Bless your ears. Bless your soul. Bless your eyes. Bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Because you are going to see it. You will be a witness.
These people did so much. Got other people grouping up with them, slandering you, spreading rumors, lying on you, gossiping about you, making assumptions, trying to set you up. Huh. Trying to play you.
How you gonna play a player?
How you gonna do that?
Come on now.
Come on now. Come on now.
You will hear the cries of evildoers, the ones who was attacking you. You're going to hear their cries.
You ain't going to cry, though.
And if you do cry, it won't be for long. Glory to God. You're going to hear the cries of the wicked that rise up against you. They should have never rose up against you, because see, they're going to be crying for much longer than you will be crying.
My God. Cursed. Doomed.
And don't worry if you see them thriving today. Don't worry if everything look okay with them today. Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry about today. Don't worry about today. It's okay. When the wicked thrive, rebellion increases, but the righteous will see their downfall. Proverbs 29:16. When the wicked thrive, when the wicked are in authority, when the wicked increase, when the wicked are multiplied, sin increases, transgression increases, evil increases, rebellion increases, wrongdoing increases. God is wrapping it up. He's getting these people up out of here. See, the wicked will not be able to stay in position for much longer. A shift is happening. The tables are turning. You will live to see their downfall.
My God.
You will live to see their downfall. If they thought they was gonna set you up, if they thought they was gonna put false stuff on you, if they thought that they was gonna be able to get rid of you, some of them gathered together to figure out how to take you down. They will not be successful.
But guess what? You will.
You're gonna live to see their downfall. They wanted you up out of here. They was ready for you to die. Waiting on you to die. Come on, man.
You're gonna live to see them die first.
Come on now, to fall first. Come on now. In the abundance of the evil ones, crime increases when crooks are in power, but law-abiding citizens will see them fall.
It's a wrap for the crooks.
It's a wrap for the scammers. It's a wrap for the criminals. It's a wrap for the wicked ones. It's a wrap. It's a wrap. It's a wrap for the schemers, the devisers of evil. It's a wrap for the setup folks. If they ever put a hit out on you, it's a wrap for them.
If they ever spread the word about you, it's a wrap for them.
If they ever made you a target, it's a wrap for them. Understand me?
Understand me?
When the wicked are multiplied, crimes
shall be multiplied. When wicked people increase, crime increases.
Come on now. This is what happens when the wicked grow powerful. But again, don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. Because we're going to walk them down.
Walk them down, Jesus. Walk them down.
Walk them down, Jesus. Come on now. God's work going to get done regardless. Come on now. Don't worry when you see the wicked thriving. Don't worry. Put it in the comments. Say, I will be a witness. You will be a witness to their downfall.
You will look upon their downfall.
You're going to see them fall. Understand is that you are being delivered from all your troubles. Glory to God. You will look in triumph at your enemies. Your eyes will stare down your foes.
You're going to be able to walk them down and look them dead in their eye.
You're going to stare down your foes.
You're going to see them live and direct. It ain't going to be nothing they can do with you. It ain't going to be
nothing they can do with you because God lining it up in such a way that they go, baby, you're going to see their downfall.
Come on now.
You will stare down your foes.
You will look with satisfaction
upon your enemies. When you get the word, it's so sad. Nobody really want to see other people sad. But I'm talking about you ain't getting no justice. You've been waiting for justice. You've been waiting for vindication. You've been waiting on God. These people was dead wrong. Dead dog, trifling and dirty. These people did you so dirty. I'm talking about
years ago.
Now, in the present. And they still keep trying to come up against you in the and
cause you to
something about your future. They trying to thwart the plans or the mission or something. But you will triumph. Put it in the comments. Say, I will triumph. Glory to God. You are being delivered from all of your troubles. From all affliction. Whatever has been afflicting you. Time is up. They out of time. Ain't no more time on the watch. It's a wrap. It's a wrap. The devil is a lie. Tell the devil to take his filthy hands off right now. In the name of Jesus, take your filthy hands off. Yeah. And we pray that whatever you're going through be released in the mighty name of Jesus. Put it in the comments. Say, it will be released. Glory to God. See, all you got to do is cry out to God. That's it. Because the Lord is on your side. The Lord is on your side. Glory to God. yeah. The Lord is on my side. He is my helper. Mm-hmm. Therefore, I will look in triumph on those who hate me. They can't stand you, baby. They can't stand you. But to make you as an enemy,
you're going against God.
They should have thought twice. They didn't know you spiritually. They just looked at you from the physical with the naked eye. They can't see you in the spirit. They have no discernment as to who you are. My God. They cannot identify you.
You are unrecognizable. They didn't know. I better not do that one.
I better not play with that one. But they're going to find out. Because the Lord is by your side and he is your helper.
He is on your side. If God is for you, who can be against you?
Where are they? You finna look left and right.
You ain't even left and right. You ain't gonna be all right, cause you got something that left, right, did my left. Anyway,
you're not even gonna see them no more. Glory to God. Psalms 59:10. God's kindness will go before you and he will let you see them defeated. My God,
to see them defeated.
God said, I am going to be kind to you and I'm going to let you see it.
They going to know not to play with you when I get done.
Matter of fact, I'm going to give you the victory. God said, his kindness is going to go before you. Okay? God will avenge me of my enemies. Put it in the comments. Avengers. Avengers. Come on now. Yes, Lord. Bring out the Avengers. Glory to God. Get your work done, Lord. Call the Avengers. My God. You will gloat over those who spy on you. They watching. They lurking.
They see you.
Yeah. But you're going to gloat over those who spy on you, over those who slander you, because they've been running your mouth. They've been running their mouth. Sorry. They've been running their mouth concerning you. I don't know, y'all. We got spies.
Somebody's spying on you.
Who's that peeking in my window? Nobody now. Man, if you spot them, you got them. You know who's spying. You know who's lurking. You know when they're spying, when they're lurking. Let me tell you something. You already know who's lurking. Chosen ones, you know we be knowing. Especially those of us who are spiritually gifted. Come on now. The Lord said, I saw you.
He saw them.
The Lord has seen the works of your enemies. He has heard your cries. Though your enemies gather against you, plotting and scheming, they will not prevail. Put it in the comments. The devil will not win.
Gotcha.
Put it in the comments. They will not win. They will not be victorious. They ain't gonna be victorious because you are the victorious one. It can't be two winners, baby. Can't be two winners. Everybody can't get top dog. Everybody can't get number one. You winning out here. You are the victorious one. Come on now. Deliver me from my enemies.
Oh my God, protect me
from those who rise up against me. Psalm 59:1. Come on now.
The Lord says, I have
set a hedge of protection around you. You will not fall prey to the wicked. Glory to God. These people thought, let me tell you something, they was trying to play it so cool. They thought that they could. I'm talking about they really.
Did you really think you could get away with that?
Come on now. You will not fall prey to the wicked.
You got to look at your haters and be like, did you really think you was going to win?
They didn't know who you was, chosen one. They didn't know. Their arrows may fly by day, but they will not find you. You shall not be afraid. Traps may be laid, but God will cause them to stumble in their own snares. My God.
Imagine setting a trap for somebody and you the one that take the loss.
They dumb. They slow. They ignorant. They a fool. Let me tell you something. When you dig a ditch, you better dig too. Let me tell you something. Listen here. Traps may be laid, but God will cause them to stumble in their own snares.
You are in a season of divine justice.
Some of y'all did not get justice in the world, and you thought God forgot about you. You thought that he was gonna let you down. You thought that it was no hope for the situation. But the Lord says it's hopeless for them, but there is hope for you. You thought that you was not gonna get justice. You thought that nothing was gonna be done about that. I'm talking about time probably could have went by. You probably let it go, forgot about it. It's just a wound in your heart. God said, I ain't forget. He ain't forget. The guilty will not go unpunished, y'all. That's law. So if you think that you can escape in the natural, you got to think about that spiritual. Because again, if they die, they're going to hell. And if they live, they're going to experience hell on earth. They're destined for that. Yeah, they should have never did that. And trust me, you ain't the only one. They've been out here doing this junk to God's children. I was finna cuss and say they've been doing this. And I really was. Because that's how serious it is. That's how disgusting it is. They've been doing people like this. It's only a matter of time. Come on, man. Come on, man. Come on, man. You in a season of divine justice. God is not blind to the attacks. Okay? And he has risen up a shield for you. All right? Your mourning will turn into dancing. My God. Your mourning will turn into dancing. Glory to God. Though the adversary, the enemy, the devil seeks to devour you, the Lord said, I already delivered you. I've been took care of that. He said, I already had it. I saw that the devil wanted to devour you, but I delivered you.
I did that. Don't worry.
Just don't look back. Don't look back. And if you do look back, you're going to smile. And you're going to look upon your enemies triumphantly happy at the outcome. Come on now. Come on now. Come on now.
I want to let you know that you are protected.
Every plan against you is failing. So if some of you didn't understand
or know how you was going to, you know, navigate certain situations, or how you was going to get them people off your back, or how you was going to get out of that situation, or God said, don't worry, I already delivered you. There's nothing that they can do about it.
Mm-mm. He said all the plans that they, everything that they planned against you is going to fail. It's going to fail. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. My God. And some of these people don't even understand the magnitude that when they decided to become the weapon that was formed against you, that they have just signed their fate, signed, sealed, and delivered, that they will not prosper. I'm talking about none of them.
And if they grouped up together, they better back out and wash their hands.
I don't want no dealings with that. They better repent.
They better come back and make it right and apologize to you.
Yeah. Yeah.
I want to let you know that angels have been appointed to guard you.
Angels have been appointed to guard you, okay? You already got the victory, okay? Your enemies, they will be scattered. Don't worry. I'm telling you, don't be afraid. Don't worry about what them people say. Don't worry about how strong they seem. How many of them. Because see, some of them, they got plenty of people. But I'm talking about it's real slaughter gang. They all gonna fail.
Slaughter gang.
I'm not joking with you. I wish I could. I might tell you a joke. But I'm not going to tell you a lie.
I'm not going to tell you no lie on here.
I promise you that. I promise you that. You got my word on that.
Listen here.
You have been given the victory. The Lord went ahead of you to secure the victory, even in the midst of chaos. Even while things was looking chaotic, he said, I already got you covered. I already know what to do. Don't worry. I got it. I got it. Don't worry. I got you.
I got you.
Yeah.
Prepare
to see the hand of God. You're going to know it was nothing but God. You're going to see God stamped all over this situation. You're going to know it was nothing but God, because the tables are turning in your favor. See, the scales of justice was not balanced, but the tables are turning in your favor. You are being lifted up in this hour. And I want to let you know that you will not just survive, but you're going to thrive. You're going to thrive. I don't know what you're going through today or how hard it may be, but you are not going to just survive, but you're going to thrive. Hear the word of the Lord. Hear the word of the Lord. See, you don't got to worry about how is it going to happen? When is it going to happen? That's not your concern. As a child, when your parent is taking care of you, your concern is just to live, baby. You carefree. Don't worry about nothing. You are a child of God. Don't worry about the hows, the whens, the what ifs, the outcomes. Don't be afraid. Because it's, let me tell you something, he already went ahead of you. He said you're going to survive. You're not going to just survive, you're going to thrive. My God, glory to God. You shall be lifted above your enemies. You shall be lifted above your enemies. Go higher. Go higher. You shall be lifted above your enemies. Glory to God. Go higher. None of their plans against you will prosper. None of their plans. Not one of them. I'm talking about they can have 10 plans. Every last one of them gone. It's going to smack them. Every last one of them going to backfire. Domino effect. I'm talking about big blows. Doosh, doosh, doosh. I'm talking about big blows. They ain't gonna know how to recover. Come on now. They ain't gonna know what to do. The victory is yours. Glory to God. The battle will turn in your favor. It's gonna turn in your favor. Some of y'all been fighting for a very long time. You getting weary, sick, giving up hope, feeling like giving up. The Lord said, don't worry, because the battle is about to turn in your favor, baby. Everything that you've been standing up against, everything that you've been fighting and battling, things that you ain't told nobody, secret things. He said, don't worry. Don't worry. I want you to lift your hands in triumph and give glory to God, because all glory goes to God, y'all. Understand this. Lift your hands in triumph. Glory to God. If you know this word is for you and you believe in your heart and you have faith that God's going to do what he said he's going to do, sow your seed at $88.88. The links is in the description box. The Cash App is there. The PayPal is there. The Zelle is there. Sow your seed in faith. Glory to God. Connect yourself to the anointing. When you send your seed, put triumph in the notes and see that no word will return void. Let me tell you something. No word of God will fail. It is so. Connect yourself to this anointing. Glory to God. Glory to God. If you cannot afford to sow the $88.88, sow what you can afford. Cover yourself. Divine protection. Sometimes you have to sow where you want to see a harvest. My God.
My God.
My God. God is so good. He is so good. Listen here. You got the victory.